interrupting, but before that interrupt is recognized by microprocessor, again it is going to the polling. It is something like this. I give 5 students token each and allow them to raise that flag when they have a question. First student asks me a question. I go there, find out that he is the one who is asking me a question. I will serve him and come back. And again, I will go to the first student only. If fifth student is asking me a question, and before that, before I serve him, if first student again asks me a question, I will end up in serving first student only. I will never reach to the last one. It may so happen here. This is the third point that we should note as a limitation of this particular algorithm. Fourth point is, after all devices are checked, it is going back to this particular routine in which it is coming out of it. That means sequential check will take time. If it is last device asking for interruption or asking some services from microprocessor, then from first device to last device, it will go through a loop. And last device has to wait. Average waiting time by devices for getting their interrupt request served will be different for different devices. First device will have large probability and chances that its interruption will be served immediately. Last device will have some delay coming out of it. But this is a very simple algorithm for implementation, and this is there for simple microprocessor systems in which multiple interrupts are allowed to be ordered together and supply a single interrupt to the microprocessor. Our system could be, we have, let us say, 64 devices as input devices in a system. We can group them, 32 devices in one group, 16 devices in another group, and another 16 devices in third group, group X, group Y, group Z. Group X we can all together and connect it to RST 7.5. group B we can all together connect it to 6.5. group C we can all together and connect it to 5.5 of a microprocessor, and all three levels will work. But basically in one particular group, this one only will be the algorithm implemented, and this algorithm for 7.5 will be there, for 6.5 will be there, for 5.5 will be there, and it may so happen that the last device connected in 5.5 group will get a very delayed chance for its interruption to get served. This will be a drawback of this particular simple algorithm. Advantage, very simple and very effective algorithm. Quickly, it can be implemented and carried forward. Let us go to the next part. And how do we implement this particular algorithm? How do we implement this particular algorithm? What are the system requirements and how to write a program for such type of interrupting mechanism? There are two methods, as I told you last time, there are two methods for implementing such algorithm. One is hardware method and another one is software method. For implementing this polling algorithm of ILS, there are two ways. One is hardware way and one is software way. Let us see how the software interrupt is going to work. How this software interrupt level subroutine is going to work. So for software part, we expect system or the architecture of the system to be of following type. Let us say here we have D device 1, and this device, there are multiple devices, so device 1 to n, there could be n number of devices here, but this particular device do have one feature, and that feature is it has flag. This is Q1 bar and this is Qn bar. We expect that this input device is there, and this input device has a flag in it. Now, this particular flag goes to a buffer, inverter buffer, and this inverter buffer is controlled by AND function. And input to this AND function is read signal of microprocessor and D1 is a number for that particular device. Similarly, the other device will also be having a buffer, tri-state buffer, and that buffer will be controlled or strobed by again AND function, input to which is coming from DN and read. Output is connected to bus or some particular D1, D0 line. I assume that there is a decoder available here. Input to this decoder is coming from address bus A15 to A1, A0, and output of it is D1, D2, DN. We assume that our circuit has this feature. In this feature, this is the input device eligible for providing interrupt. There are multiple devices, 1 to n, but each device has a provision of flag, and flag is the inverted output Q1 here, likewise Q2, Q3 up to Qn. Each devices, they do have their respective flags. The output of this flag is connected to a buffer, and this buffer is controlled by output of AND gate, and this AND gate has input read and D1. What is D1? D1 is coming from this particular decoder. This decoder is getting address from microprocessor for that particular device. You know that input devices or output devices would have a particular address. That address, when provided here, will appropriately generate D1, D2, D3 or D4. In polling, what will happen? Microprocessor will provide address for device 1. The moment device 1 is selected, decoder D1 output will go 1. This 1 will appear here, and when microprocessor is going through that ILS process, it will generate read signal. Because of this read signal as 1 and this device as 1, output of this AND gate will be 1, and because of this output gate 1, the buffer will have a strobe open, and because of that, the output from device Q bar will get inverted and it will appear over here either for D0 line or D1 line. Microprocessor can read this line and microprocessor can understand that this is the device which is interrupting. How is the algorithm? I will repeat it once again. We have devices connected. Microprocessor is polling. While microprocessor is polling, it will generate address for first device. That address will appear here and output accordingly will go low or high, D1. Now D1 is connected to this AND gate, the input to which is a read 1 from microprocessor. Since microprocessor is checking which device is interrupting me, that microprocessor will put read signal also, and once these two signals are selected, this buffer will allow this flag value to go to one line of data bus, and the data bus content will come to accumulator and microprocessor will simply read that content of accumulator, and if microprocessor finds that this content is 1, it will confirm that this is the device which has interrupted. In our previous flow chart, we had shown one diamond, and in that diamond we are asking, is this device providing interrupt? Answer is yes or no, and this decision would be taken in this particular fashion. Microprocessor sends the address, device gets selected, and once this device gets matched with read line, buffer will provide the output. It will go to D line, data bus line. Microprocessor will collect that value to accumulator and check whether this value is 1 or not. If it is 1, it will consider that this is the device which has passed interrupt. Output from data bus to a microprocessor will not be 1 if this particular gate is not selected or this is not the flag causing output to be 1 on a data bus. So microprocessor in that case will find out that this is not the device which is causing interrupt. It will increase the address to a next device. D2 will get selected and process will be repeated for D2 device. If it is not there, it will continue polling till the last device is connected and then go ahead. So for software polling of this particular type, we should have a device in which there is a flag present, this one. And one more thing, once this flag is read by the device or a microprocessor, this flag should go high once again, so that next time when microprocessor is again polling this device should not falsely tell microprocessor that it is interrupting once again. And then only we can expect the sequential polling to happen and then go ahead. Simplest possible software polling is this one. And it carries a drawback. It carries two drawbacks rather. First one, being a sequential, the last device will have to wait longer for getting the interrupt. And second, we expect that this device should be cleared. If it is not, microprocessor will land up in a particular loop only and the effective algorithm may not function or produce the final result. Is this clear? Okay. Now, let us go to what is called as a hardware polling. Hardware polling will expect following kind of an architecture for our hardware circuit. I have OR gate here. Output of OR gate is going to interrupt of microprocessor, and input is coming from various devices. This is device D1, this is device D2, device Dn. This D1 is coming from slightly complex input device. And now, this device 1, similarly, I will have device N here. Will have two different blocks. I will call it as a code generator. What kind of a code? I'll explain soon. First block is code generator, and this one is interrupt status flag. Interestingly, it will have output Q1 and Q1 bar. Similarly, this flag will have Qn and Qn bar. What I do is I AND Q1 bar with device generator sequence number, and the output of this AND I connect to next device. That is, this code generator will get output of AND, input to which is from BGSN-1 and QN-1 bar. And finally, the output of device is connected to a bus, which is my data bus. I would expect additional call instruction generator circuit, which is driven by interrupt acknowledge from microprocessor and gets connected with this particular data bus. Let us see how this particular algorithm is going to work. Let us see how this algorithm is going to work onto such type of an architecture. Why it is called as a hardware structure? Because this particular device is more intelligent than the previous one. We had drawn input device in previous architecture in software pooling, and there we expected device to have only flag value. And flag is simply a flip-flop. The moment you press a key on your keyboard of a computer, this flag will go high. and the moment that flag goes high, interrupt will go to microprocessor. Microprocessor would know that interrupt has come, and microprocessor will attend to that particular interrupt. So single flag of output type J, JK or SR flip-flop type is good enough for those kind of input devices. But now we are expecting this input device to be somewhat more intelligent, in which we have flag plus we have one more intelligent circuit called as a code generator. Let us see how it goes. Interrupt is generated by some particular device. It goes to microprocessor, and now microprocessor wants to know which device has generated this interrupt. The final answer out of this would be microprocessor will not poll. Microprocessor will not poll, but microprocessor will come to know as to which device has generated the interrupt. So under this hardware polling, what is happening? Interrupt is generated. Interrupt is acknowledged by the microprocessor, and because microprocessor is acknowledging, on data bus, microprocessor will get a value which is address of that particular input device which is causing interrupt. Let us assume that device 1 is the device causing interrupt. Since Q1 is becoming 1, Q1 bar will become 0, and this particular Q1 will go to OR, output will be 1, microprocessor will receive instruction as interrupt. And because of this interrupt received by a microprocessor will generate acknowledge signal, interrupt acknowledge. If you remember, pin configuration of 8085, we have interrupt acknowledge pin onto that microprocessor. So interrupt is received, there is an interrupt acknowledgement generated by microprocessor. It comes to this particular circuit. This circuit is somewhat special circuit. This is the circuit which is working for microprocessor to find out which is the device causing interrupt. And I'll call it as a call instruction.